Yes, it's a Wednesday, and it happens to be Woman Crush Wednesday. I will let you know who we are crushing on in regards to Scoop. But as of today, Josephine told me to tell you that she wants her to be our woman crush on the show. I told her I'm tired of having to read commentary on different social media platforms with everybody asking where she's at. She has explained something that apparently she's going through certain things. With her body, her body has not yet allowed her to be on camera, and we are not even body shaming. But when she's ready, she's definitely going to come on camera and just say, you know, what up? So stop asking, you'll see her. Whew. That aside, my name is Tina Fierce. One, the show is Scoop and Scoop, proudly sponsored by Fanta. Let's get it. Aha! Because yesterday, I told all of you, yesterday we were like, given it's March, we're going to be celebrating women in this month. We wanted to do something special for every episode moving forward. Just, even if it's just 5 seconds of us celebrating a woman. Then, when me and the team sat down, we just thought of a scoop angle. And then something hit me. Reniel, when was the last time you saw, what's her name? Catherine Kusasira being all NRM and being all those things that she was. Have you people noticed she's not on the scene anymore? Have you people noticed that the last video that was outed was actually a very, very, very old video? That video of her in a car with money and another chick? Very old. Leave that alone. What happened to all the NRM artists? Have you heard Butcherman say anything? Is anyone here in full figure say anything? Meanwhile, she joined my sister station. She's going to be working with us. And everybody thought I would feel some type of way. Ned dance and baby sitting her friends and family. Bwembandi wa kubandula nja kubandula. Full figure na here, Sidika. Before we know it, she's actually looking for a day job. What happened to the way these people were telling us? Senta Zanze, we are in this thing. Tuchirina, Faba Chirimu, Wowe, Wololo, Walala. What happened? Josephine, I have a theory. Remember the last episode we did when we were like, oh snap, we just gave them a magazine. I think that Ish woke them up. And not just Full Figure, Butcher Man, you know, all those other cartoons that were around. Balaam too. Has anybody seen Balaam be all about my president lately? Oh, he quiet. They are quiet. Now, today the team, nebuzebi, oh, man, Anjiri, we know. I was like, woo-hoo, what's going on? So apparently, the reason you're not seeing Catherine Kasasira, Full Figure, all the people who are on the president's payroll, so apparently, someone, finally, people, different parties actually managed to get through to our president. So these Kadeides who wanted his money just can act like as though they are trying to help his cause cannot finally access the president. Last time I heard, they were telling me the same group of people, Baringa Basato, Bakatarini, Obanani, Bagezako no Gende, General Salim Musalenga, Bagaleda, but influencing, Neva Bagamba, nope, Muriba B, Muriba Yai. I was like, wait, what? Now this doesn't mean that they are not, but wait, if you're not getting the president's money and you're not influencing, what do you think you are to the president? No, you're dead and forgotten to him. He doesn't even know of your existence. Because the last time how we noticed that my president was going to leave these people high and dry is when they asked him if they were on the payroll, and they were not on the payroll. What happened to Full Figure's car office? Yali yakubye mizimunga ina ka office kenga kanzi chikizanga mureke sina na kamuvumoya. She had a car office. Obasha was advising them on what I don't know. I think at Wemba Tunulira, they're desperate. They're going to keep making some type of what noise, but the president is done. He's done with them. He finally, it hit him. It was not a strategy. Apparently, Catherine Kusasira, bamgobe mu nyumba jabadde apangisa ate not just jabadde apangisa ng'abeeramu waliwo gy'akoleramu ebizigo bye I didn't know naye ayina ebizigo bamubanje to a tune of about 5 point something million so that makes me ask nze nenfuna access to the president of this here nation and you tell me with all the money he has been throwing my way from the jump I couldn't get like 120 milli and go buy me a house correction not build buy me a house there is ready finished houses chimambala babanaye obugaga sibwa buli omu waliwo abantu abagenda okusigala obunaku n'obunaku because sibwa buli omu in that ne wobateka mu sent obwongo bwo bwaganirayo muki munaku bali munaku banaku wabunyo and I felt so bad and I know how bad this is going to sound but according to a few sources on the ground we are trying to build the evidence apparently waliwo abadde agenda n'agamba omulala n'amugamba omanyi sente bazisibye mwekalakaseemu kaawo mukube ku buvulwawo munyiigemu omusajja asumulule sente between my government my NRM people and a particular opposition party it's getting dramatic before you know it I have a feeling we are going to be told so much a lot it's about to get really really ugly but I'm going to sit back and enjoy it because when I heard these allegations I'm like wait we always knew it was a ponzi scheme for everybody to get theirs but what we didn't know is that the joke was not on just us it's on the perpetrators too So some smart chap, again, remember I told you about a smart ninja who came and he copyrighted the whole nyege nyege and blankets and wine, something, something. Well, guess what? Another smart ninja, though I don't know how smart this one is, has come out and copyrighted fresh. So in a nutshell, bana kambabuli na bantu begwanga. Munda bankola zino story. Munsasire, have some patience with me. There is nothing much a sister can do. It is what it is, but so no guy yagenze mubalo yabe nasanga ngelinya fresh anything terina copyright twina ba fresh jaja ba fresh kidi ba fresh daddy fresh ntumbwe fresh anything ba fresh banji he went and he actually registered it under his copyright right and then like that wasn't useless enough He had the audacity and the time to tell us Mbu is even going to sue everyone who is called.
Erinya nali wandisiza kubanga ebanga deni libadde nga ndikozesa nga lona abalala balikozesa naye nga bw'omanyi nti sawa zino nina ebintu bingi buli kintu nze kyenkola nkiligolayizinga mu ngeri yange okuba nti siri muntu eyerimbika mu kino na kiri fresh nali gazeti nze ekigambo nga fresh omuntu wadde mbukikozesa mu mboozi ze eza bulijjo naye okukyeyita nti fresh kid fresh jaja fresh daddy fresh manager ngana nga bemba nti fresh mayor lwero kati nze nagazeti nze fresh ng'omuntu yenna okuddamu okozesa ekigambo fresh ng'erinnya lye ateekwa okubanga afunye olukusa okuva ewange kuba nali registerinze
like uganda jiji ebyokola bibuze Muri wano mkanya kuoga na you're broke. These are the results of being idle and disorderly. Like, I wake up in the morning and I'm like, oh snap, I could actually make money from this. You see, we're trying to steal cultures that are not yet ours. We're heading to those cultures, you know. In the first world, you can easily sue. In the first world, you can actually copyright something and it is actually your thing. And like an entire corporation will have to bend down low so that you can give them rights to access it. But yeah, fresh. What is Fresh Kid going to give you when you sue him? What? His holiday package? Why his homework? Or part of the crayons that he keeps in his bag? What? His do-rags? He has very many do-rags. He could give you a purple blue because he comes in different colors. What is fresh Jeju going to give you when you have... Now, for most of you who have seen Nina Rose, you understand that her story has been something, right? Most people don't actually know her story, but when I was talking to a couple of people who know her backstory, because we did, one of our journalists actually did a story on her back in the day when she just came out. And it was found out Nina Rose, apparently, mama oya muzala na msula kuchi kukasasiro. But that's besides the point. I'm going to give you the full details on that one tomorrow. Today, it's a different story. I just felt maybe I needed to throw that and then maybe they could judge for themselves. So I woke up in the morning to about 5 phone calls from 3 different stylists. One is something else. They all work around celebrities and they all had one complaint. It was you, Nina Rose. Nina Rose apparently bomwamba zengo yezo antitezibazise mbara bantu bagamba ezange njazambara zange. Otherwise someone would be doing a story like this on me. It's quite embarrassing if you ask me. Anyway, apparently these stylists, makeup artists, photographers, management, all these people all together bakukoye Nina Rose. The reason why they were saying this is Nina Rose to sasura echo church soka Nina Rose bwatwale ngo yezo zera bide tagenda zikudiza ata tagenda nakosa sura. So it's like maybe she's broke, but that girl just has a song that she has a few two songs and I think she performs every once in a while. So they're like, no T, this is not even about her being broke. So I'm like, what else? They're like, Nina akole ebintu binje kati. Now I'm going to start a different PSA. Nina Rose, get off cocaine. Get off the cocaine. First of all, you is too broke to support a habit like cocaine. You can't afford it, Nina Rose. Va ku cocaine. Omuntu yandigambye va ku njayi. Nze sijja kyogeranga njayi. I've said cocaine, coca, powder, that one. Jiveko, Nina Rose, jiveko. Because this, we can speak on it with authority. If you think we are tukwidimbirira nyabo tubulire wona woli, we shall just make you pee in a cup and find out, because everybody knows you do too much cocaine. Everybody knows it, and that's what is lagging this girl behind. I don't even know who introduced her to this nonsense, because you are not such of a big star to begin doing cocaine. Right now, the type of star you're on, you are allowed to be doing a cigarette. You are not as demented and as broken as all these other celebrities who are doing cocaine, but that is even besides the point. You cannot afford cocaine. You cannot. How much is an ounce? Last time I checked, a gram goes for like about 300K. 300K to 400K. That is the money they use you, they book you for an entire day. Like I can book Nina Rose in the morning. Nemugamba himba mpaka yabunaziba. Nemuwaga. Ana. Nina Rose banai. Nze sigenda chiru mamu. You have treated very many people off. Like everyone is mad. Down to people who I know personally. You and Bini Ganta were bad days like crazy. Bini and Tim and all the people who used to sit with you fell out with you because of coca, because of doing cocaine. Then you stupidly moved on to look for a new group of people who can accept your bad habit. Now we again are joining Ba Wizo. What is funny about Wizo but we're joining Mbu? Apparently this is what they do. Kage nani katula nabo, ne kabagulira cocaine ku centers de Catalina, ne baka sekerera, ne bako ogerako. Nina, obugulu uba bwachi tula kalida terera. You are not such a big deal yet. If you want to make from this industry, stop it. Stop it. Singa na abadaga ambari kunjai. Enjai non woto andi gambako nino abayimbi bayaga. Ekugwa komudachika sat, you are doing lines. Lines. Nina Rose, lines. And you people thought she's just naturally skinny. No, the bitch don't eat. The bitch can't afford to eat because she's a junkie. She cannot. She's a junkie, full-time, full-blown junkie. Oh, yes, Petty Betty came out. Josephine, it's actually Wednesday. That's when Petty Betty always comes out. Ah, ngasina basibula ngamazo kuvuma Nina Rose nobuunga bwe. Bakubuunga Nina Rose badenche country dem. So, the Ministry of Gender, I remember I talked about this last week. She's still having a go at Fresh Kid. I do not know what Chichi does to Tachita. Why does she even call the media? This is where it bothers me. Yes, the story gets to me, Zengo ama uli rechinsanjina. But if she's honestly doing this for the well-being of this boy, why involve the media? Why make sure that the story gets to us? Tata wa Fresh Kid itazito wa kido chenda. Mwa inzo kulema an entire ministry. Ochitegera, mwa inzo kazi inga koka saja nange nze kenyini nkesi tulida. Kako kakota kota. But you still manage to call the press so that it gets you a what? I don't know what is wrong with my country. Anywho. So apparently, as y'all remember, atemwe Uganda mwa babi de tabino, you people were the same ones who are like, kana, kali talente di, bakaleke kakole, kakabi, mbajukida mwe babi de mwe, you're to blame. Nga mwatuvuma. Oh, mwatuvuma. Because he's now 8. It doesn't matter. I have an 8-year-old in my house. That guy is clueless. The guy in my house, my 8-year-old, is just thinking about Thor, what Thanos does, who is the Green Lantern. That's what people of his age are supposed to be thinking about. Anyway, that's besides the story. So apparently the minister and Fresh Kids management and dad, when they decided to let him work and study at the same time, there were a couple of things that were put in order that was supposed to actually be followed. One of them was that since he is going to be getting an education, as he is also working, they should open up a bank account. Now on that bank account, for whatever performances he makes, there should be a percentage that is thrown to that account. And that percentage should pretty much cater to his tuition, it should cater to his well-being, just general stuff. And they expect that money to reflect on the account. So, new developments, Yavitandika last week, which doesn't really bother me. New development is they actually found out Mutata Fresh Kiddy. There was no account. And now it's such a big scandal. They put it in the papers. They're going to put it everywhere. Stories are running. I'm asking. You got Omusizi wa Chutix okuve Masaka. Nalyo kwa agwa mu fame. Femu nga sina we wa mutabani we. Nafuna ko we. Nemumwane audience, nemumutuse wa minister. What did you expect of this man? Like, why do we have so much wishful thinking? So you people actually generally, you are genuine, you thought he was going to do these things. Like the ministry sat there and they're like, yeah, ingeri javiri mu minister ya Uganda, tajia kulemerewa jabikola, are you kidding me? First of all, two words, minister, Uganda. Same sentence clearly means won't be done. It's like when you say certain things about my, it's like saying something about the parliament in this country and anyone takes it serious. But the parliament passed a bill to, we'll all be like, the parliament did what? Beva man. Like, why do we have so much faith? I'm on our way. Baba genda musirani, samusirani. I'm on our soma. Yafuna basare mpakadi. Life. It's a life bursary. Bamuleka kukampala parents so bara jivu ne rupare here. Since they are in that charitable mood and they are rich. Kona waka bandolinga off waka gate na wana bara jivu. Tanazara kozi. Ezo na chotu jiveko. Like to chase on you. Because I don't know. So now, Basa anze sente tezidi yo. Then what? They are going to stop Fresh Kid from performing. Where has he been performing? Have you people seen any kids' events lately? October when we are celebrating Simanya Gurini, Uganda, Go Gurini, Bibulubia. Nambole, Yafaya, New Vision, yet they say, Bagenda performing. Because some of the things that they told him, he cannot do performances in the night. So where is he going to perform? Wali abana babandi banji. Mbote baina na basare, te baina na sudiru, te baina kebalina. and their fathers are douchebags, their mothers are losers, they are also trying to see if they can come to a minister and say, under your ministry, tubadde tusaba feba tuteke mu UPE. Naye minister wange alobedde ku baserebu beba kwegamba ye alaba bebeetaaga obuyambi bwe, other than opening up a situation where she can say, kale mulabanga bwe twayamba Felista, mulabanga bwe twayamba Fresh Kid, omwana nga olieyo and you're talented and you know you can actually get an education and still work, mujje tutuule tulabe what can be done for these kids. Like abana tuyo banji ababonaabona. You see, you can get those same kids and you tell them, no, you cannot work right now, but I can teach you a skill after school. Because these are kids who have no futures, none. Na yoli ko Fresh Kid ya ina basare ya life. Aina nechitawe, atula mu motoka. Asobola no tugambe yo tozeyo. Ali ya kukonflexi, nga wali wabali kukubo. You have failed me as a minister. And on that note, without further ado, at Tina Fierce One is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop and at Tina Fierce One. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's at Tina Fierce One with an H, and on Snapchat it's Tina Fierce One. Nina Rhodes, Vaku Kafa. What is it called in Uganda? Vaku Buwunga, Nina Rhodes, Vaku Buwunga, Buveko. And on that note, like I told you, I'll be celebrating a woman every day. Woman Crush Wednesday. It could be the good one or the bad one. Well, guess what, Nina? You made my first spot. You are a Woman Crush Wednesday. You say, I'm out. Peace.
Scuba Scoop is sponsored by